A successful re-roofing project begins with measuring your roof. If you don't want to climb a ladder and get up on the roof yourself, you can get an estimate from the ground. If you want to take more accurate measurements, you can climb onto your roof. This article will walk you through each process step by step. So, we are going to watch about the how to measure a roof.
Method 1, taking measurements from the ground.
First is find the length and width of the building's exterior walls. Estimating the area from ground level is less precise than measuring each side individually. Stretch your tape measure along the walls from end to end in both directions. Add these figures to your recorded measurements to account for the additional area.
Step 2. Calculate the pitch.
The pitch is the steepness of the roof. To find the pitch of your roof, you'll first need to set up a ladder tall enough to reach it. Place a level against the rooftop a few feet in from the edge. Step 3. Use the pitch multiplier table to determine what figure to use. Pitch multiplier tables make it easy to use a particular pitch to estimate a roof's square footage. Run a search for pitch multiplier table and look for the measurement of your roof's pitch in inches on the left side of the table. Step 4. Multiply the area by the pitch multiplier to get the roof's square footage. If your roof measures 48 feet, 15 meters, by 24 feet, 7.3 meters, multiplying its length by its width would give you a square footage of 1,152 square feet, 107.0 meters if its pitch is 6 in 12, a pitch multiplier. Finally, divide your estimated square footage by 100 to estimate your materials. Roofing materials are bundled in squares that contain enough shingles to cover 100 square feet. Dividing 1,290 square feet, 120 meters, by 100, for example, will tell you that you need to order at least 13 squares to.
Method 2. Diagramming your roof. First is find a safe way onto the roof.
If you have an interior window that provides roof access, use it to step out onto a secure section. Otherwise, it will be necessary to set up an extension ladder and climb onto the roof. Step 2. Measure each side of the main section of the roof. For square or rectangular roofs, you'll only need to record the length and width. For sloped sectional roofs, write down the dimensions of each individual plane. You are just looking for the outer perimeter at this stage.
Step 3. Measure any additional structures separately.
If your roof features any architectural elements like hip ridges, valleys, or dormers, don't forget to find the length and width of these areas. These measurements will factor into your calculations and, therefore, the amount of materials you'll need to buy.
Step 4. Record your measurements precisely.
Don't round your roof measurements up or down. This will be done once it's time to determine the number of shingles you need. Write out each measurement exactly as it appeared on your tape measure. Step 5. Draw a diagram of your roof on a large piece of paper. Make a rough top-down sketch of your roof. Then flesh out your diagram with details like ridge lines, hips, valleys, and dormers. Step 6. Use the measurements you took to label your diagram. The idea is to reduce your roof to a series of lines in order to simplify your subsequent calculations. Write down the length and width of each corresponding section of the roof.
Step 7. Divide the roof up into simple geometrical sections.
Keep lining off the different parts of your roof until each section is a square, rectangle, or triangle. For example, drawing a line across the tapered end of a gabled roof will create a long rectangle connected to a small triangle. Step 8. Multiply the length by the width to find the area of rectangular sections. If a section is 120 feet, 37 meters, by 100 feet, 30 meters, its total square footage would be 12,000 square feet, 1,100 meters. Be sure to find the area of any dormers on your roof, as well. Step 9. Work out the area of the remaining triangular sections. The basic formula for finding the area of a triangle is 1/2 the base times the height. If you have a roof section that's 30 feet long and 12 feet high, multiplying those dimensions would give you an area of 180 square feet. Step 10. Add up the areas of each section to get your total square footage. Punch each of the area measurements you deduced into a calculator one by one. The sum of these numbers is the overall square footage of your roof. Finally, divide your square footage by 100 to estimate your materials. Roofing materials are typically packaged in squares, each of which is the equivalent of 100 square feet, 9.3 meters. Dividing the total area of your roof by 100 will help you figure out how many squares worth of shingles to.
We hope it is useful to you. Please subscribe to our channel to upskill yourself.